Greetings everyone and welcome back to my channel. It's been a minute since I've uploaded any new content, and right now I'm getting ready to update some of the offerings on my altar, as well as add some new offerings that I got confirmation from my ancestors of them wanting me to add. So I figured this would be really good content to share in regards to people wondering what they can put on their altar and how to put things on their altar, because I do get that question and sometimes I have questions myself. So I thought it'd be really helpful. And of course, I'm not going to show my altar because I'm past that stage in my journey from when I first started sharing content on my YouTube channel, but I will be showing the offerings, what I'm doing and why I'm doing them. So let's jump right on into that. I changed out the flowers on my altar yesterday. I picked these daisies up from Publix, and it was something about this pink that just really stuck out to me. It felt like and looked like love, like the pink is just symbolizing love for me. So I chose those for my altar to replace the roses that I had on there. I have my root chakra candle burning from a friend of mine. Her candle business is called Amour's Alchemy. And I have the whole chakra set and I love them all, but I definitely have some favorites, with this root chakra candle being one of them. And I decided to light this one to keep me grounded in this energy as I work with my altar. So already setting the vibe, setting the energy how I want it while I do all of this work with my altar. Now, as I said at the beginning of the video, I'm going to be changing out the current offering. So I do keep a glass of alkaline water on my altar, a shot glass of Scotch whiskey, which you can see back there. I do a cup of coffee beans, because you don't have to do liquid versions of coffee or make a cup of coffee, anything like that. This will suffice as the coffee offering, and I just really like it because it's very aromatic. Like, it makes a really nice smell on the altar when you first refresh the coffee beans. I had rose cologne in here, but as you can see, this is all they left. I'm trying to show without spilling it, but as you can see, that's all they left from that rose cologne offering. Now I'm going to be refreshing all four of these. So new water, new shot, new coffee beans, new spiritual water. But then I'm going to be adding in some food, which these are going to be things that stay on my altar, which I'm planning to switch out weekly the same way that I do my offerings here. And I'm going to store them covered. So I'll show you how I'm gonna go about doing that. So the first thing I got, and none of this is sponsored by anyone, these are just things that I chose for my altar for specific reasons. My Baba, he loved Snicker bars, like six packs at a time. Not eating all of them, but that's how we would buy them for him. You know, the little six pack you can get, and he would kind of just stash them away. So I got the minis, and I'm planning on putting three of these on my altar. And I'll probably share them with them, of course, because, you know, sharing stuff. I got some dried ginger, which I love eating these, really good, perfect spice. And I love ginger because my mommy loved ginger, like ginger lemon honey tea for when you're sick, when you're under the weather, when you just want that kind of tea, that comfort. So I feel like this would be a really good dried food that I could put on the altar for her and keep it covered. But I have a way that I'm going to keep it covered. And then I also got some organic almonds because my mom was really big on organic foods. So I got these. All of these came from Publix, by the way. So I got these, and I'm gonna mix these with the ginger, so that way, the way that I'm planning on storing them, I'll be able to open it when I'm in this space and close it when I'm not. So these are the new things that I'm adding. And I don't remember where we bought these little bowls, but it's basically like a little glass bowl. And it opens, if I can actually open it, it opens at the top. So when I'm in this space, my plan is to open this, and when I go to sleep at night, I'll close it. And this will help me manage the fact of any bugs being, attracted to the smells of the ginger or the almonds. Because we live in Florida and we tend to have lizards come in the house and things like that. So yeah, this is like my safety measure. So I'm gonna go ahead and wash these, because I do wash this glass. I wash this and I wash the little bowl that the rose cologne or Kananga water or Florida water, because those are the three that I typically use. I always wash them out. I kind of just rub this out with a wet napkin versus fully washing it, but I dump the coffee beans out. Okay, now we have clean containers to store offerings in. Offerings in. And fresh alkaline water. Now, I'm not sure which spiritual water I want to put on my altar, so I'm going to actually use my pendulum to ask. So I have Florida water, rose cologne, and Kananga water. Now, this is normally the go-to for ancestral work. It's actually in the properties. Florida water is too, but in the sense of cleansing your altar, and then rose cologne just has like that loving energy. So I've been using this lately, and this has been what they have been demolishing. But I want to just confirm in the spirit of this video. So I'm going to get my labradorite pendulum. Okay. I'm trying to make sure I position this in a way that you can see everything and it doesn't hit anything. Okay, I moved everything back so that I have space for this. So, show me yes. Show me no. Show me yes. Show me no. Do you want Florida water on the altar? Do you want rose cologne on the altar? Do you want Kananga water on the altar? Kananga water on the altar? Okay, thank you, Spirit. My ancestors have spoken, so we are going to do Kananga water, and I'm going to do it full Kananga water. I'm not going to dilute it with any water, because sometimes I do like 25% water, 75% of whatever I'm putting on the altar, but I just want to give them the full thing today. So the rest of that, and I do typically, when I'm working with these, with the Kananga water or the rose cologne, I keep them tucked underneath the shelf of my altar, just because these are theirs, so it just makes sense to me. So I'll slide those back, and then these I'll just stick back where I had them. So I'm gonna go ahead and put the Kananga water on my altar. My hands are super shaky, so I'm trying not to spill anything. I'll go ahead and put the water. I'm gonna go ahead and add the shot of Scotch whiskey. Now, it is because of my uncle that I know to use this specific brand, because he told me that my Baba used to drink this and that my mama used to use it in spiritual work. So this has very, very strong significance, and I love putting it on my altar. I love that connection that it has to my family. Oh, I'm gonna put that top on there that tight. So I just pour it. I guess you fill shot glasses up. I don't typically take shots because I'm a full drink type person and I like sweet drinks. But yeah, I fill it up as much as I can. I'm gonna try to move that because that might actually be a little too full. But I'm gonna put that on my altar right beside my High John the Conqueror root. Let's see. Oh, shaky hands. Yeah, I'm spilling some. Hold on, we gotta abort the mission. Abort. Okay, I poured a little out. I don't know what came over me. I got a little heavy handed there. I'm trying to still dry my fingers off, which now I feel like it's too low. Let's try to top it off just a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay. Okay, so that is done. Now I'm gonna do my coffee beans, which I just used the Dunkin' original beans. I'm actually almost out, so I'll probably be using the rest of this, and I'll have to get some more the next time I go to the store. It's like a little corner left. But that's about how much I fill it up. Now for the Snicker bars. So I'm gonna do three because three is very significant to me. And then my bowl. Now I'm gonna eat some of all of this because that's a part of me like sharing the offering with them. But I wanna, of course, not be chewing and smacking on camera and get this done for them first. So I'm literally just mixing the two together, putting that top on there, and while it's on my altar, or while I'm up and around my altar, I'll have it open, and when I go to sleep at night, I'll close it, and then that'll be our process. Now that's done, I do have one more thing, because when I decided that I wanted to do, or when I asked for confirmation about things they wanted added to the altar and if they wanted food, I got yes. But I also asked, now this is just moving as I'm talking. Stop. Well, partially stop, so we'll work with that. But when I was, I think they like what I'm talking about. When I was asking questions about food, they told me yes. And then I asked if there was anything else that they wanted me to put on my altar, and they told me yes. And I'm still working on figuring that out, but I had a question that I wanted to ask, so when I do that on the video, show me yes. Show me no. Show me yes. Show me no. Do you want an offering of herbs on the altar? Do you want an offering of herbs on the altar? Do you want an oil offering? Do you want a protection offering? Okay. Okay, so that's actually in line with what I was thinking. Okay, okay, all right. I hear y'all, I hear y'all. Thank you, Spirit. So after I finished that previous part of my video, I decided to eat some ginger, you know, like start sharing the offerings with them. And I don't know what they put in that batch of ginger. Not put, because you know ginger is naturally spicy, but this was extra spicy. Like, I couldn't even finish chewing it. It was like this whole side of my mouth is just burning. Oh my God. Like, I did not remember it being that spicy the last time I had it. Ridiculous. But anyway, what I wanted to say to wrap up this video, which I hope you learned something. I hope this gave you some insight on how you can put offerings on your altar and how to increase the offerings. Not saying that you have to, but for me, I always feel like the more that I can give them, the better. Like, I feel like that's a way that I can show more love. And it's not a requirement, it's just for me, that's what works for me. So I hope that the video gave you some insight on the things that you can put on your altar and how you can work with your altar with the offerings and things like that. Sorry, like my mouth is still hot. But what I wanted to say, because a friend of mine actually shared this with me yesterday, because the question that I had asked regarding additional things, when I said that they wanted something else added, but I wasn't sure what they wanted added, and now I kind of know. But yesterday I asked one of my friends to see if she could do a mini reading for me, because I actually had just had an ancestral guidance reading done by her, and that was so insightful, like it got me together. But I was asking her for insight on that, because at the time when I asked them the question the first time, I wasn't sure what the additional things were they wanted on the altar. And I've done herb offerings before, and I've done oil offerings, like depending on the oil. So that's why I asked those questions first. But then when I asked if they wanted something protective, I immediately knew what it was. Now, I don't really want to say what it is, but I know what it is. but I was asking her regarding food because I've done food offerings before, like full plates of food when I've cooked, but I don't cook as much as I used to, and I felt like I don't really want to give them food that I didn't prepare. But she kind of put it to me this way, where she said that she always gives her ancestors a portion of whatever she's eating, regardless of what it is, where it came from. She gives them a portion and she leaves it on the altar for that day or for that period of time while she's eating. And then when she's done, she'll dispose of it. And the way that she explained to me was a few ways that she disposes of it, but she said that she'll use a white paper towel, I guess, to put the food in the paper towel and wrap that up and throw it away, because white kind of serves as a shield. So that stuck out the most to me. So I'm going to start doing that for more ways to share food with them, giving them a portion of whatever I'm eating, keeping it on my altar while I'm eating, or at least getting rid of it before the night ends, because we don't want bugs. And I did do a full food offering before, like I was saying, but I did a plate and I covered it with foil and I left it for, I want to say 24 hours, I think, somewhere in that time, but it was covered. And I don't remember how I released the connection to dispose of it, but I know I just threw it away. But I said something to kind of like release it and thank it for what it gave to my ancestors. So I didn't really like that method because it seems risky to leave the food out that long, even though it's covered. And the way that she explained it to me just made so much sense. So I wanted to share that part too, just in case it can help anyone else, because it has definitely helped me. I haven't done it yet, but actually I haven't even eaten anything today. So it helped me, and that's definitely what I'm planning to do. Maybe not every time I eat, but I definitely want to start sharing more of my food with them. So that's all I have. Like I said, I hope you found this video helpful. I hope you got some insight if you needed it. If you have any questions that I'm able to answer, definitely comment down below. Don't forget to like this video, share this video if you have anyone that's interested in working with an ancestor altar and trying to figure out ways how to do so. And yeah, subscribe if you are here and haven't already. That's all I have. Thank you.